And when it sat upon them with clovers of fire, like fire.
To rest upon each and every one of them.
You see, God is a consuming spirit.
Oh.
God is fire.
Amen.
John baptized, you see, I'm baptizing you for repentance. With but water. He said, God, one come after me, he got baptized with the Holy Spirit and fire.
Hallelujah.
And that's what we're talking about. We're speaking about the fire.
Hallelujah.
That Holy Spirit can consume,
hallelujah,
can clean,
hallelujah,
can wash,
hallelujah,
can purify your life,
hallelujah,
can bring your life back just like Jesus' life.
Hallelujah.
Holy.
Holy. All right. Look at what he said here,
Lord,
in Acts chapter 2. We're having a good time, church. You having a good time with us? You get excited because let me tell you something. The promise of the Father can be for you this morning.
That's Amen. Right.
Oh, I tell you, he's a gift to every believer.
To
every believer. I believe in a triune God. We believe in a triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Because in the book of Genesis, it doesn't say, you know, but in the book of Genesis, it says what? God made, he said, let us make man.
Let us make man.
In our image,
he
in our
actions. He and Jesus.
That's right.
That's right.
And the Holy Spirit was there because he hovered. The Holy Spirit hovered over the earth is what the Bible says. But look what it says here in Acts chapter 2. He's talking about the coming of the Spirit. He said, when the time of Pentecost was fulfilled, okay, they were all in one place together. And Brother Joe, what they were doing? They were praying.
Praying.
They were in unity.
You know, some people say you don't pray for the Holy Spirit. We're saying right here.
Oh, yeah.
He was in that praying. I can show you scriptures in there with this praying.
Yeah.
Praying for the Holy Spirit to get come upon them.
And then what happened? And suddenly there came from the sky. He said a noise.
A noise?
Like
a strong driving wind, Glory.
And what it did? It filled the entire house in which they were.
There.
And look with them tongues of fire, what you're talking about.
As a fire.
He said that then there appeared to them tongues as a fire.
And resting on what?
Which parted and came to rest on each one of them.
Everybody in glory. Everybody can come over there.
Yes. They were about 120 over there. But I tell you what, you who watching today.
You can get it too.
Oh, you can get it too.
It's for you too.
It's for everybody.
That's what the Bible says, for everybody.
For everybody. It did not stop with the upper room.
What did he say?
That was just the beginning.
Hey, Glory. He said, all who call upon the name of the Lord
shall be saved, and they can be filled with that Spirit.
Be filled with the Holy Spirit.
Let me tell you something, Brother Joe. How different are our lives today compared before we were filled with the Holy Spirit? Come on, testify.
Glory.
Testify as to how different your life is.
Look, that changed your life completely.
Talk about
I was lost.
All right, now.
The Bible says we was far away, lost.
All right, now.
Is the truth from earth to heaven. But you know one thing, Glory.
All right.
You know, through praying, and I guess my mama's in prayers,
yes,
and our grandmother's prayers.
Yes,
and
we made it
for
in.
Us, we made it in. Mm-hmm. That's why we can't condemn nobody.
No, that's why we got
we
to
always
keep on
far
praying.
Away.
You talk
ain't
about.
And what we do, Glory. We pray in love.
Talk about.
For them,
talk
and
about,
they're going to come.
And they're going to come in.
And Glory, look here. I have a testimony. Listen, I have a brother. He drank a whole lot.
Uh-huh. All right.
And you know what I mean? Look at the Lord told me to pray for him.
All right.
I prayed for him. I put his name on the cross.
All right.
And Glory, look here. He quit drinking and everything.
Praise God. Praise God. Isn't that awesome?
You have to go and condemn nobody
prayers.
And just love them the way they are.
Amen. Because, you know, this is how God loves us. That's Jesus
the,
loves us.
The Bible says when we still were sinners, he died for
he
us.
He died for us. He loved us.
Now, Glory, think about ooh, you dying for a sinner.
There you talk about it. I couldn't imagine
that's
doing
kind
that.
Of real
thing. I wouldn't imagine doing that. But it took a spotless Lamb of God.
A spotless Lamb
hallelujah.
Of God. And Glory had to take. We're talking about the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And you know that's why Jesus, he came from heaven.
Was able to
John 3:16 said, God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son. Begotten Son.
Yes.
That me and Luke Glory, he didn't have to come to receive, like we got to receive
yes,
Jesus.
Yes.
You know, he came already received.
Ooh, hallelujah.
But he had. We know you did. But we understand this. He still had to get filled with the Holy Spirit after
that's
he got
right.
here.
That's right.
Because he wanted to be just like us.
Yes.
To show us
to
how we
us.
Got to get around in the world and how we got to be an example to show others in the world.
Amen.
Praise
amen.
The Lord.
In other words, we need the power.
We need the power.
We need the power in order to be able. You see, he sent the apostles back to Jerusalem, back to the upper room. He said, you stay there until you receive power from on high. Now, they were with him. They stayed there with him for 3 years. But he says, you're going to need some fire in order to continue to do what I did. I want you to go out and heal the sick. I want you to go out and cast out devils. He wants you to go out and do the work. But he said you're going to need some power.
Well, listen to this here, Gloria, and we can go to the scripture. We're just having a good time.
Yes, what you are.
Having a good time. Listen to this here. In Luke chapter 4, John was baptizing.
All right.
And when Jesus stepped into the water, God had spoken to John already and told him that he'd be able to recognize him, who he was. And when he spoke to John, didn't want to baptize him, but he got John to baptize him. And when he was baptized, the Spirit of the Lord came upon him.
That's right.
Like a dove.
Yes.
And he's led by the Spirit in the desert to be tempted by the devil.
Yes, Lord.
But notice this. All the temptations that the devil put on him, he never would fall from. Jesus says, written. And he would take him in an instant and carry him all about. He says, it's written.
Yes, amen.
But when Jesus, listen at this. But when Jesus came out of the desert, notice good. That's when all the miracles started. Everything. That's why he said when he got in the synagogue, he said, what? The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he have anointed me
Hallelujah.
To do these things, do all this. And notice, his ministry just popped off with fire. Uh-huh. And just like us, Gloria, it's like what you're doing.
All right.
Nothing didn't really happen until you received the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Until I realized that I needed it. That I needed that power.
And Gloria, what you needed? You needed it, and you're seeing that others needed it too.
Exactly.
That's why, Gloria, how long have you been having this?
This ministry is going to be 4 years in December.
Okay.
4 years in
what
December.
What led you to that? We know the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit. That's right.
And to let more people know more about the Holy
Spirit.
Exactly. Now, Gloria, you're not saying nothing wrong about everybody speaking about the Holy Spirit.
Oh, no.
But you know what I'm saying? God wants you to let's tell people from your heart what God done for you.
Exactly.
Amen?
Exactly.
And you know, that's what the testimony is all about.
Exactly.
What God done for me.
Praise God.
Ain't right?
Praise
what he's done
God.
For me.
That's right.
And that's why you go and tell others, because what he done for you,
exactly.
Look where you was.
Exactly.
And what he took, where you was and where you at now.
Exactly.
And you just tell people, make some difference where you at.
That's right.
You're never too far from God.
Amen.
When you call on him, man, he'll hear you.
He'll hear you.
Amen.
And he'll come to
the
you.
The Bible said, the only thing can keep
rescue.
God from hearing is in Isaiah 69. He said, our sins is the only thing that separate us from God.
Hallelujah.
Without our sins separating us from God, God going to hear us all the time.
Amen. Amen.
And God is faithful.
Oh, he's so faithful. Because you know what, Brother Joe, this morning, you and I are here together.
Praise God.
Now, you and I didn't come to rehearse anything, but because God is our Father, and because we have the power of the indwelling Spirit, we said what we were going to come and do. We were going to come and talk about the Holy Spirit. But I tell you what, we have all kind of things written down. And I tell you what, the Holy Spirit of God is going to bring forth what needs to be done. Because maybe we got something written down that the Holy Spirit says not necessary. You just let me speak through you. You just avail yourself. And I'm going to tell you what it is that you must speak to my people, you know? And this is what it's all about. Now, could we come here and do these things without the power of the Holy Spirit working in our lives? Oh, you would cut your television off. The viewing audience would cut their television off. Why? Because there's no fire. There's no salt. There's no water,
that's right.
You see? But because we have been filled with the Spirit of God and receiving an infilling of the Spirit of God on a moment-by-moment basis, God is able to use us to bring the good news of the gospel, to let you know that this kind of power is available to you upon your yes.
That's right. And Sister Glory, you know what I'm saying? I tell you, God always wants you to go with some kind of little agenda.
That's right.
You know
to be
I mean?
Prepared.
Be prepared.
That's right.
If, you know, if God can, if you can do that, God knows he can take you far.
Oh, you're talking about.
Now listen, you took that scripture there, and you could run that scripture all day long.
Exactly.
Just that.
Exactly. Exactly.
You know, that's what it's so. Because what you spoke about the Holy Spirit.
Right.
Look, the Holy Spirit, what the Bible says, he'll teach you all things.
Exactly.
That's the truth.
That's true.
You know what he'll do? He'll teach you about the present and the future.
Amen.
He'll tell
things
you things.
Things that are here and things that are
and
to
he'll
come.
Tell you things.
You know, he warns you.
You know, and that's what we're talking about this morning. You know, some people, you know, they talk about the Holy Spirit. That's why God wants you to know the Holy Spirit so much, because he can speak to you. You see, the Holy Spirit is a person.
Amen. He's a gentleman too, huh?
Just like that. And listen to this, Yoda. And he love you. The Bible says don't squinch the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So you know what I mean? Let's all be real.
Amen.
You know, we speak in this word this morning about the Holy Spirit, about the power. And we all can look in the world today. We look at the news. Everything was going on. Look like everything is falling apart everywhere.
Amen.
Everywhere, everywhere, everywhere. Listen at this. You know why? Because the Holy Spirit is in the world. Yeah, don't get me wrong. But they haven't received the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
They haven't received the power of righteousness.
Amen.
You know, when you don't receive the righteousness, you don't be righteous, you steal, you'll do all kind of bad things. But when you have the righteousness of God, when you stand up there righteous, Jesus said, God, he's righteousness. And we have to have the righteousness of Jesus in us. And we have that kind of righteousness in us. Listen, I'm a guarantee we're going to do everything what God told us to do.
Amen.
In Ezekiel, glory, Ezekiel chapter 3, the Israelites was cutting up till they couldn't cut up no more.
Praise God.
And listen, they'll go in those God's people,
uh-huh.
The Israelites.
Yes.
And they'll go places where the heathens was, and they're like, just like the heathens. You know somebody else is doing it out there? Just like the heathens. Look, and God got mad at them. God said, he told them, he said, you know one thing? For my name's sake, for my holy name. In other words, y'all is supposed to be bringing my holy name. Y'all supposed to be holy, and y'all doing that? He said, look what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this old stony heart out of you.
Wow.
And he said, I'll put you a heart of flesh in
Hallelujah.
You.
Hallelujah.
Then he said, I'm going to lead you and guide you, and you're going to do just what I want. And then look what he said. I'm going to take you and send you back to them that them heathens.
All right.
And you know what I mean?
All right.
And when they're going to see you, they're going to change and come to, and be like you.
Hallelujah.
And that's what God do with us, glory.
Amen.
Glory, God let us go back. I go back oftentimes to Grand Coteau, where I was born and raised at. We do wake service there or funerals, wherever we do that. And look at people telling me, Joseph, we knew y'all long ago.
Praise
we
God.
Knew how y'all was, but look how y'all done changed. That's what we're talking about. Then look, we go back to them same people where we used to cut up there and drink and cut up, and we go back there and worship God.
Praise
and
God.
Tell them about Jesus. Isn't that wonderful?
Isn't that wonderful? It is awesome, Brother Joe. Our time is just about 4 minutes.
Glory.
Yes.
I know.
You know, things go very quickly.
We're having a good time.
Yes. But you know
Let's
what? God has God got his message through whatever time we have. God works through
and
that,
so
amen?
True.
And we believe in it by faith. I thank Brother Joe, I thank him so much for being here with me this morning. And he's going
to
be back. We're going
to
continue on talking and building
Amen.
Up God's people.
That's right.
Giving you a hope in life.
That's right.
A new hope in life that God is on your side.
Amen.
So what can the world, the flesh, and the devil do to you? Come to know Jesus in the pardon of your sins.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody this morning, you don't know Jesus in the pardon of your sin. Come with a repentant heart and ask him to forgive you. Ask him to fill you with that spirit that you saw in Brother Joe and myself today. Ask him to fill you. Ask him, oh, just repent and say, Lord Jesus, I come before you just as I am a sinner. Asking you to forgive me of my sin. Cleanse me of all unrighteousness. Create in me a clean heart that I may know you, love you, and serve you in this world. For I want to be happy with you in the next. Forgive me of my sins. Adopt me, Jesus, into your Father's kingdom. I repent and I declare you to be my Lord and my Savior. Until next week, next month, know that I love you with the love of Jesus in my heart. May the Lord bless you real good.
Real good.